Alright guys, here we go. Hello and welcome. This is gonna be a monk, healing monk, should I say. And this guy has a lot of treads involved, so let's check his gear out. Okay, he's pretty fat. Alright, I like this guy. I like this guy already. So this should be, hopefully, a fairly easy run. But we'll see how it goes. So yeah, a lot of the guys have been asking for... Well, initially I put out a video of me doing, I have been putting out videos of me doing runs through instances as a healing monk, because there isn't too much of that content out there, and I know a lot of streamers play monks, because, you know, everyone wants to see a monk, wants to see how they handle most stuff, but a lot of them are actually tanking monks, and I haven't actually seen too much, too many streamers, too many... videos. There's a fair few videos out there, sure, but I'll just be putting out as someone leaves the queue, which is kind of weird. I think that dude was just handing in, but whatever. So yeah, hopefully this guy's taking a little average. So hopefully this will give you guys an idea on how a healing monk handles, how it runs. I'll try and go through the process of what I'm doing as healing, but one of the problems is that I have a tendency of just either ranting on about random crap or not speaking at all. So hopefully it's the first one. At least that way I'm speaking and, you know, there's nothing. It's just dead silence. Yeah. You know what I mean. So monk healing in a nutshell is kind of just going around and meleeing stuff. That's basically how it's done. If you need to heal, you do your channeling heals. You know, if people need heals desperately. If not, if, you know, everyone's at about 80% health, you don't need to really worry about it. You just go around and punch stuff. And the passives, as well as the healing orbs, which no one ever picks these up. If you're watching this and you're not a monk, or if you're anyone, please pick up the... Please pick up the healing orbs. Oh my god, as you saw there, there was about... And the tank leaves. Awesome. This is going to be a good run. I can already feel it. As you saw there was about a whole ton of healing orbs just chilling. So, yeah, if you're a tank, please pick up the healing orbs. And this DPS goes in. This is going to be... all sorts of fun. Is that tank? Is he here? Is that him? Nope, sort of front. Well, hopefully he figures out he can walk here eventually. And we'll get this on the way. I'm not friendly. Okay, is he heading here? Looks like this. Punch that cat. Come on, Darrington. He's a warrior. Now, I think warriors complement monk healers the most. I'd always have the least warriors when healing a warrior healer. Now. And he's a torrent. So I personally like warrior healers more. Warrior tanks? Warrior healers. Ha! Warrior tanks more than any other tank. Paladins. Basically, paladins and warriors are probably... I don't know. They seem to complement being a monk healer the best. I don't know. I've just personally had less issues healing them. Not than any other kind of healer. Sure why, but any other sort of tank, but yeah, I'm not sure why, but that's what I've come across. Either the tanks have been the bad tanks have been. Oh, I missed that. Let's grab this one. Grab it and run it into this group of guys. Everyone's following me. Boom. All right. Yeah. So. I can already tell this is going to be a completely random video, but it's still monk gameplay, so I guess that's all we're here for. Lightning Barrels is awesome. But yeah, this is the Stormstout Brewery. It is heroic version. And it's not too bad. I'm not too sure I've actually done this on heroic, I don't think. I think I have, now that I think about it. But yeah, actually, I'm pretty sure I have. Either way, it's I'm sure we've all done that in the normal anyway. Yeah. Let's get to it. First boss, it is Ukuk. I'm not too sure if my shrine's up, so I'll just throw it up again. Pretty sure it was at the door, but I don't know. But basically, being a monkey, like I was saying before, is all about mealing stuff and just beating stuff down. That's about it. You have access to other abilities if you need the healing, i.e. this AoE healing. Always keep that on cooldown, always keep that chaining, because it's just awesome. It's good chi generation as well, so always keep that rolling out. You can jab as well if you need to get the chi stacks rolling. If you don't, then you just worry about the soothing mist. Is it soothing mist? I believe it's something else. Reduing mist. I knew it was one of the two. That's it. Let's avoid those barrels. More barrels. Jump on the barrels. Collide the barrels. Straightforward fight, really. Nothing out of the ordinary. This instance is fairly easy as well. Personally, I found that all these heroics are too difficult. If you want to compare them to something, I remember when the counter first came out, so many people were having issues with the heroics because mainly because of the way they completely revamped healing, I think was probably a major kind of issue to that as well. The fact that, you know, everyone had to relearn how to be a healer. Well, not everyone, if you already knew how it worked. You didn't really need to. But basically, they changed the way healing works back in canon, right? So, any fat loot? Any fat loot? Plate, healing, boots. Do not want. And go right. So yeah, back to what I was saying. They completely revamped the way healing and Kata worked. So I think that contributed to the way that heroics were kind of difficult. They felt difficult when they first came out in Kata. Personally, I was kind of expecting the same kind of thing here in MoP, because the way it was just the way it is. When heroics first come out, everyone's going to be in, you know, green slash quest blue slash, you know, 450 blues they get from rep, or, you know, the final two instances, you can do those, you level up, drop 450 blues, which are good. That was also good. I believe the item level requirement is 420, I think? Or 430? I can't really remember. I'm sorry if anyone was curious, but I can't really remember. Either way, I mean, you can get into heroics fairly easily, especially now since they released a hotfix that basically was like, hey, we're gonna remove requirements. Got these guys around. Best way to get rid of them. Yeah, they recently announced that they're gonna remove the reputation requirements. Oh, this is gonna be bad. I can already see it now. Yeah, they removed the reputation requirements on Justice Point Year, so now a lot of people were complaining the fact, well, you know, I've got all this Justice Points gear, but I haven't really been doing dailies, so it's just gonna be wasted. A lot of people were complaining about the fact that, and Blizzard has gone, they were like, okay, fair enough, we'll remove the reputation requirements on Justice gear, but the reputation requirements will remain. I should actually get out of this AoE. There we go. Will remain on Valor Point gear, which is obviously the epics, which is good. I like it. I like it quite a lot. Yeah. Now let's hope that these bombers get knocked out, because I wouldn't want to wipe. Bombers. Oh, this is not good. I'm getting stunned. Just T. We need that mana. Stick. Alright, we're good. Good to go. Now you may be, yeah, so they have removed the requirements of that, which is good, and we should get out of that. So let's do a barrel roll over here. Oh, he's coming right at me. Okay, we'll do a couple of barrel rolls over here then. Still got the hammer on me, which is good. Still got six stacks of it. That's awesome. see if we're in this, so just under half a minute. It should be enough. T, and then there's a bit low. There we go. 25 seconds left. We will actually start pumping these guys up because. Alright, good. Successfully avoided the imminent death comes with those guys dropping their bombs. Stand here for a bit while we wait. And I'm gonna have to go and grab myself another hammer, which we will do that right now. Alright. Yeah, this guy's got HP, but he'll get healed. Eventually. Yeah, so that's good. So you can now head on over to, I don't know the zone, what it's called. It's one of the last zones that isn't Dread Waste, the other one. Bots should die. It's kind of a bad barrel roll, but regardless, we're still out of it. And there he goes. Good cloak. That is a really that's a really nice cloak for healers. But I already have it, so we'll just go ahead and grade that. Heading on down to the last boss. Let's take a check at his loot. Actually, does he drop any good things for healers? Decent ring, but I think I already have it. Yeah. So. I haven't really talked about anything, really. I mean, this is the brewery. It's a fairly straightforward instance. Being a monk, like I said, it's just you gotta roll up and beat on stuff to heal. I mean, it's not a hard thing. When I first was learning about the monk, you might have seen it in my previous videos, I don't actually go around mealing stuff. And it was like, well, it always felt kind of weird to me. It was just like, this doesn't seem right. Like, it felt like I was missing something. Obviously, the meleeing part, but there was, you know, it was just, the chi generation didn't feel fluid. The healing was kind of awkward. It was just like, well, I've just got my hot, and, you know, surging mist and soothing mist was the two main heals. And then you got this big old enveloping mist, or enveloping? Enveloping. You know, the big heal, and then that was it. You've also got, you know, AoE heals and then the certain talents you want that heal and DPS, and, you know, it just didn't feel right. Something was missing. Also, the fact that the statue, you know, it was just like, well, it just does another soothing mist on... Yeah, soothing mist. I'm still getting used to these names. It just does another soothing mist on someone when you use it. So it's just like, oh, well, like, I guess that's all right. But reading around through the talents and the spells was like, hey... You know, things do things, and it was a bit like when I like this one, for example. Also empowers your serpents, you with zeal, causing you and your summon the jade serpent statue to heal nearby injured targets equal to 25% of your auto attack damage, stacks 2 times. So I was just like, well, I don't know where that guy was dying. I'll go ahead and heal him. And there we go. Put your statue down, and we'll go beat stuff up. So yeah, so it was just like, well, I guess I am supposed to go in there and beat stuff. Like, it always felt weird to me, like, I don't know. Coming from other heroes, I mean, I've played every class in this game, 85s, what have you. Coming from other heroes, it's definitely a weird thing. Gotta get out of this disorient stuff, by the way, if you are. Watching this video for the strats, for whatever reason, I don't know why, the strats aren't here, it's just, it's fairly straightforward. There are some kind of strats in the last boss, actually, which I will go over, which is kind of interesting. And it can vary, depending on what spawns and stuff. But yeah, so healing and monk, I personally think it's one of the best classes to heal, it's one of the funnest classes to heal, because you're up in the action, you're beating stuff up, you're actually doing some sort of offensive ability, so I personally enjoy it. I reckon it's the best healing, I don't know, in terms of can I speak English today, please? Thank you. How viable they are in raids, I've never raided, I haven't done any raids yet on this monk, I have raided, but you know what I mean. I haven't had any raids on this monk just yet, so I haven't seen it. Looking for raid opens in next week. Raids open tonight, I believe, actually. What's tonight? Tonight is one. Is it Wednesday? Oh, raids should already be open then. Alright. Well, there you go. Raids already open. So, raids open looking for raids open next week. Normal raids open now. They should already open by the time you see this video. And, yeah. Fairly straightforward stuff. Let's go ahead and throw some heals on this tank. There we go. Knocked around is awesome. Okay, alright. I need to be all poopy about it. I'll stand out for a bit. Okay, there we go. Let's quickly take a quick drink. There we go. Adds a spot. Let's roll. Now these adds, as I horrendously misclick that, but whatever. These adds have these beam things that you see. What they do is they heal, but you can also step into them to intercept it. Then you got to focus down the ones that aren't getting healed. Pretty self-explanatory. Unfortunately, it does require some sort of coordination. So, things more often than not do not get killed very quickly. Now, keep in mind what these mobs do, because there is a chance that these mobs do spawn. Go ahead and interrupt that, because why not? There's a chance that these mobs do spawn during this last boss phase, so you need to be knocked on 100%. As you can see, that these mobs are not dying. Look. Oh, this mob's not dead. Let's go and finish it down. So, it kind of requires some sort of coordination, I guess, in the sense of, let's all focus this one down. He doesn't have any heals, so it seems like the logical choice. Good news is that the heals, these beams that you actually interrupt, do in fact heal you. And it also gives you mana, so you're free to burn as much mana as you want. If you're a mage or whatever, you can sit there and spam. You don't need to worry about mana, conservatory, being conservative. That's even a real word. Like I'm doing, I'm spamming offensive abilities, which isn't really viable as a healer. But I can do it because I have this infinite mana. There's the debuff there, you get 2% of health and mana every second. So it's pretty good. Just finishing up the last of the mobs. Oh man, these mobs. Come on, you can do it. Good thing with these mobs though, being a monk healer, is that you can generate a full stack of chi brew, or whatever it's called, mana tea. Just greed those. Don't need greens. Last wave and then the boss. Come on. Statue's still up. It is good. Yeah, so good thing about those mobs is you can generate a full stack of mana tea. So it means when you hit into the boss fight, you're going to have a lot of regen available. Which is awesome. Because it's always good having regen for bosses. Never want to go home. And I should slow down on the deeps. Let's actually drink some chi. And just focus on healing at the moment. Because a few of the guys are taking a bit of damage. So let's just work on that. What I will do is... get out of that stuff is the first priority. Hopefully the tank will move. But he's just gonna... he was just gonna eat it. That's fine. Go back into the melee. Hopefully that guy moves. I don't know where he is. Under the tank. He's not gonna move. Hopefully he is. See, the funny thing is, when you stand in that stuff, you take damage, you get a debuff, and you also are unable to cast any spells. So, if you are slightly paying attention, whatever attention that may be, that's not actually, you know, there's shit under you, move out of it, but whatever. You'll notice that you're not able to do any abilities. And you'll be like, hey, what's going on? And hopefully that'll trigger it. That'll trigger it to be like, oh, I see. Let's quickly just chug down a drink as fast as we can. The boss gets pulled, and of course he goes straight for me, so that's fine. But here we go. Alright, so let's check what this guy has. Bloating Brew, Yeastly Brew, and Fizzy Brew. So Fizzy is carbonation, which is, I think, the bubbles. I believe it's the bubbles. What the bubbles is you'll see it eventually. I'll talk about it then. Yeastly is the minions, which is what I was talking about before. There they are. So they will become priority. I'll mark it up so everyone knows what's going on. As they do in fact heal the boss, so you have to get in the way to interrupt it. Which no one is doing. It's just me. But that's fine. Yeah, Warlock's figured it out. Shadow Beast is a bit confused. We'll see. See, the only problem is these mobs need to die, or else the tank will never... The boss will never... You know what, I will go ahead and just tell the group, because whatever. But anyway, what you see now is the carbonation phase, which is the entire ground becomes the yellow, beery kind of thing. Similar to what we saw a few seconds away, where I was just ranting about people not moving out of it. That's the case. And no one's still killing these adds. This is gonna be a long boss fight. Let me just spam this a bit. Hopefully people figure it out. If that's not the case, I don't know what is. Either way, good news is that I have a constant supply of mana, so we'll go ahead. Now, I think they're just sitting interrupting the beams, but there's going to be a point where there's going to be more beams than people. So, killing the adds is easier and quicker than just blocking it and zerging the boss. And this add is not being interrupted. I wonder if there's an achievement. I wonder if there's an achievement to not kill enemies. Let's see. Alright, so this boss is not going down. Because these adds are still up. I mean, you can... not strategically. Oh, no, get out of it. I'm just going to kill adds, because I reckon that's probably the best. Go ahead and hop inside of this guy. I leave him somewhere, whatever. Grab a bubble. Yeah, so about this carbonated ability, let's actually talk about the strat, shall we, instead of me just getting sad about people not killing adds. Anywho, so this carbonation ability, what he does is he sets the entire floor onto carbonated, whatever it is, and you have to hop into a bubble and float up just a little bit so you're off the floor, and that's pretty much avoiding that ability. Pretty straightforward. The second ability this guy has today is the minions, which you see me diligently. I should stop using big words because I cannot speak English. Killing these adds because... But yeah, the second ability he has today is these adds, which need to be killed, or blocked, whichever, but I still think killing him is the way to go, because this boss is still only just under 50% health. Either way, doesn't matter. The third ability that this boss has today is, in fact, the, what's it called? Yeast or something? Yeasty Brew, that's it. And what that does is, I believe that he puts stuff on people, and it's called Bloat. Now, we'll see if we can find a debuff. Damages and knockbacks allies to either side, so pretty much just try not to be next to your friends when that happens on you, and good things will happen. So that's that. That's the boss in a nutshell. He does have various other abilities as well. He only has a chance to get three of them at once for each boss fight, so each boss fight may be different. There is one that makes you light. So there we go. Adds are now down. Good times, good times. So what, there are other abilities which were not covered in the studio, unfortunately, but they're pretty straightforward. One of them being the fact that you jump extremely high and then you have to jump over lines of stuff that fly at you. I mean, it's fairly straightforward, none of the ordinary. Now this boss is finally going down, and the yard's been cleaned up. We'll get to see if there's any good loot. Hopefully there is. Oh, he's doing carbonation again. Hop into a bubble. Fly up just a little bit. and to get back into it. This is kind of like Magister's Terrace. I don't know if you guys remember it from Burning Crusade, the last boss in that. He threw everyone up in the air, but you didn't have to click on your own bubble, but he threw up anyone in the air, and if you touch the ground, you get thrown to the roof and extra damage done. It's basically the same kind of mechanic as that. And it's a tanking ring, so we're going to upgrade those things there. But yeah, it's pretty straightforward. So there you go, hopefully you enjoyed this. I don't know if I like talking, it's kind of weird, but I guess, like, it wasn't really weird, it's just like, well, it's just me not really talking about stuff. I don't know. Tell me what you think anyway down below. Improvements and stuff. More and more videos will come out. I'm still slowly working on my warrior. He is 88 at the moment, so he will become a tank and get some tanking warrior perspectives as well, and eventually every other perspective in the game as I eventually level everything up to 90 and get him geared for heroics. Alright, awesome. We'll see you in the next instance, guys. Thanks for watching.